Hey friend, you've probably spent years cultivating your piano playing, but it still feels like your playing is lacking beauty and spice. You'll find that since many of the Piano Players coaching group classes are live and interactive, you can get your questions answered and find something new to learn every week. These weekly classes and coaching sessions will allow you to play live or send in videos so that you are given specific tips on what you need to work on next. So get inspired, because it's time to boost your confidence by mastering fills and chords, learning how to flow when playing songs, shake off that fear of playing by ear or playing in all keys. You can search through the coaching group database of lessons to find the specific areas you want to work on. There's no getting behind or keeping up. You follow the learning path you want. That sounds amazing to me. You'll find this group of mostly women to be your virtual besties. We're all in the same boat, face the same struggles, and find ways to push through. There's nothing more inspiring than that. So make sure you get on the wait list, because it opens soon. I'm here cheering you on. PianoPlayersCoaching.com. Happy Monday, you guys. I wanted to do a small music department live Q&A today. So I'm answering your questions. Whatever questions you have about working with a small music department, you can ask those in the comments below. I'll answer them. This has been fun. We decided to go this route a couple weeks ago, and you guys have had a lot of questions about small music departments. It's interesting because I've had two music ministry positions, two music director positions in my life. Hey, Kitty. And in both of those positions, we did a lot of training, from training sound and media and tech people, lighting people, to vocals, worship leaders, choir directors, band leaders, bass players, guitar players, drummers, second keyboard players, organists, like piano players, the works, like training everybody. So there's a lot that goes into it, and I have a few tips. So somebody was asking last time, and I thought it was a good question. We were talking about vocals rehearsals, and somebody was asking, how much time do we spend on warm-ups, prayer, and versus how much actual practice time we do? So remember that I've mentioned in the past, hey Jackie and Bethany, thank you guys for joining. When I go into rehearsal, it's pretty intense because we're going non-stop. I know the songs. I know the order of songs I'm going to teach. I know exactly what parts the choirs are going to do, what's unison, what's parts, what the soprano part is, the tenor part. So we can usually learn about three songs in no more than an hour. Like, if you really know, as a director, you really know three songs, you should be able to teach them in no more than an hour. Hey, Bethany. So our preliminaries are about maybe 15 or 20 minutes. It depends on whether I show a vocal coach video. We are enrolled in the Cheryl Porter vocal, I forget what it's called. It's a vocal workout series. And I play that for our team because I want to strengthen their vocals. And sometimes it takes a little longer if we do that. But we start at 6:30. We are usually out by 8 o'clock. With vocals, no later than 8:15, but we rarely ever go past 8 o'clock. So their tongues are hanging out by the time we're done, but we learn our songs and send them home. I let our team know that it's a priority for me to respect their time. So, okay, next question. What do you do about musicians and singers that are always late to practice? So if you guys are just joining, I am answering your questions about music ministry. So if you are a part of a small music department, ask your questions here and I will answer them live. Okay, so for people that are always late, let me back up and say, always start on time as the leader. So what we've started requiring of our musicians is, in order for us to start at 8:30 on Sunday morning, the band has to be there at 8:20. You can't run in at 8:30 and start playing at 8:30 and get your chord charts out. And we have extension cords on all the music stands just in case somebody needs to plug in their iPad. So they get all their stuff set up, put your in-ears in, make sure your instrument's tuned, make sure the loops are brought up, everything's plugged in, you're ready to go at 8:30, okay? Which requires me as a leader to be there early as well. So we always start rehearsal on time. 8:30 on the dot, we're playing. We start the loop, we run through the set list. So, I'm trying to think back when musicians didn't really come. I mean, sometimes we'll have some of our younger ones who show up late. It depends on who it is. If you have young people that are a part of your band that depend on their parents to drive them, I'm a little more lenient on them because they don't have control over getting to church. They don't have control over their siblings. A lot of things are out of their hands, so I tend to have a lot of mercy on them. I will communicate with them if it becomes a bigger problem. I try to figure out ways for them to get there earlier or talk to their parent for them to bring them earlier. If it's somebody who is an adult and can drive themselves and get themselves to rehearsal, I would consider what's going on in their life. Here's what I found. Just from personal experience. Hey, Carmen. Hey, Cranford. Jude. Is that your first name? Is it Jude? I have found that when you set the level of expectation that you start on time, people tend to show up. I'm trying to think of the people in our church. We rarely have people that show up late. And if it's anybody who shows up late, usually they have heavy things going on in their life and they're just trying to get there as quick as they can. So keep that in mind before you ever try to approach somebody and maybe cause a problem, especially if they're dealing with issues in their life. Try to be sensitive to that as the leader. But if they are constantly being late, you can talk to them. When I talk to people about conflicting issues, I try to approach it from a way where I'm not judging them or saying, hey, I noticed you've been late to practice. What's going on? You know, sometimes that can be a little confrontational. Whereas if you said, hey, I'm just, let's meet for coffee, you know, what's happening in your life. And usually if you try to go around it and find out about the person, the things that are affecting them coming to rehearsal late will come out. I've told this story before, but I had an alto one time who was consistently late. I'm talking like 10 to 15 minutes late to rehearsal. And that's a big deal when you have a 30-minute rehearsal. And I had people on my team who were pressuring me like, she's always late, she's always late. But I was trying to use wisdom. And one day I really felt like that her life was so draining at the moment because her son, who had been coming to church, was no longer coming to church, and he had been a part of our praise team. And so somewhere God gave me wisdom in the back of my mind to know that for her to even come to a sound check, for her to even be a part of our team, was draining the life from her because it just reminded her of her son. So one day I pulled her aside and I said, it's hard for you to minister on the platform without your son, isn't it? And she just broke down crying. And it still makes me emotional right now when I think about it. And she said, yeah. And you know, from that moment on, she was never late again. Yeah. So just having that conversation, letting her know that I recognized where she was and I saw her pain, gave her the freedom to just let go of it. So working with people is tricky business. Sometimes you try to set a hard and fast rule, like, you know, if you're absent for more than three times and you get taken off, or if you're late more than whatever, but you just have to use wisdom and, sorry, there's fuzz or something flying around, and try to discern each situation, because some people's work schedules are different than others. Some people have dire home situations that, you know, church is their sanctuary and being able to be on the praise team is a strength to them, and you don't want to take that away from them. So that question, I would say that would rise and fall on you as the leader. to start on time, make sure you're prepared, walk into a rehearsal confidently, make sure your rehearsals aren't confrontational, aren't stressful. I make sure as a leader that I'm taking time before I ever walk into a sound check, I'm taking time to slow down, to breathe, to relax, to run through the set list, to make sure that I'm as the least amount of stress as possible so that I can have a smile to give to my team. Because if me as a leader, if I walk in late and stressed and, oh, I'm not sure about this, what are we gonna do? You know, it just sets the whole team off. And that'll happen to your team members too. If they're coming in and they're feeling stressed, they'll feed off of that. That's gonna affect your pre-service rehearsal because everybody's stressed out, they're snippy at each other. And then that's gonna affect your service because it just bleeds over, okay? So those are great, great questions. If you guys have any more questions, if you are a leader in your music department, I'd love to help you. You have a very high calling and you guys are the cream of the crop. So I'm here for you whenever you need it. We do have, for those of you who don't know, I do have a group called the Piano Players Coaching Group. And we do live classes every week. So we'll talk about things like this. We work through, you know, songs and teaching songs to your team and all kinds of different things at the Piano Coaching Group. It's live classes, like I said. It does open in the fall, so you want to make sure that you get your name on the wait list. It's pianoplayerscoaching.com. If you are a music director, a music minister, if you play the piano already, I would highly recommend that you join this group. There's a lot of great content, a lot of great resources and videos that will help you keep growing as a leader and a musician. All right, you guys, if nobody's told you today, I believe in you. You have what it takes to be an incredible leader and musician. And I will talk to you guys later. Bye, everybody. Notification popping up. Hold on.